Good morning. So excavation is the process of digging out. So you dig out the clay. If the clay strata is very dry, you pour water in stages and excavate. You get a mass of clay which is moist mass of clay. That lump of clay will be piled up and will be subjected to alternate weathering, day and night. It will be subjected to weathering. Exposed to daylight and the night, 1 or 2 days you will keep it there. Then you, if at all it is having any debris or any vegetable matter, it will be seeds like that, it will be removed manually. Then add sufficient amount of water content will be increased. Then you go on tamping it, either using the leg, 4 or 5 people will be, just you will make it as a frustum of a cone, then you will pond it at the center, pour water, using the implement, spatula, a crowbar, pickaxe, these are the implements, construction implements, shovel. Using that, you go on mixing with water. If it seems to be very less in sand, add fine sand. Little fine sand into it. Then 4 or 5 people will be tamping. The first process of mixing it with water is known as kneading. K-N-E-A-D-I-N-G. Kneading. Then this tamping is known as puddling. Puddled clay. Either you have manual tamping or you have pug mill. You have pug mill, where this clay will be put and it will be puddled. So pug mill is the place where you put the clay and mechanically puddle it. So after kneading and puddling, it gets sufficient timber. That puddling is the process of tamping to induce timber, timbering the clay to make it more plastic. No? Then there will be mold, ready-made mold, either in timber. Nowadays, the molds are steel mold, so that its durability will be more, frequency of use can be increased. Very many molds, because you need brick in thousands, in 10,000s. For even a small residence, you need around 20 to 30,000 bricks. So, this brick which is puddled, tempered, after oiling, lubricating the sides of the mold, you will have a steel plate at the bottom. Mold will be kept, it will be greased or oiled. Then using a shovel, a trowel, not a shovel, trowel, using a trowel, put in stages in layers. Using a kneading rod, fill without any gaps, go on applying small tamping, fill the mold, then brim it out using a straight edge. There will be a straight edge or a wire. If you do this it on a ground, then it is called ground molded brick. Ground molded brick. There are specific table, so that ergonomically the person who is working on the mold need not sit and do it. So the output of the brick will be more and the efficiency of the work will be more. So table molded bricks and ground molded bricks. In a table molded brick, instead of a straight edge, if you are using a wire, thin wire which is very straight, tempered, tight wire, starting from one end to the other end, trimming off the material above the top side of the mold, then that brick is called wire cut brick. Only thing, table mold brick, ground mold brick, whether you are using a straight edge, all are brick. But this specific brick which is cut, trimmed using a wire, then it is called a wire cut brick. Usually wire cut bricks are factory made. So the process of kneading, process of puddling, process of tempering, process of molding. These are the stages by which. So the natural material is clay, but you are going to make a brick by baking it. Brick is by baking. Making of brick is by baking. That is why we tell that it is a semi-natural material, as pottery is. Pottery is also made by baking. It's a small scale industry or a cottage industry. People who are almost at the brim of poverty line survive. Their life, they carry on their life with the limited income they get by using these potteries, by excavating the correct clay. They know they are very much affluent in selecting the correct clay, because pottery's thickness will be very small. So clay from the shores, sides of the river. The advantage, if you take the clay from the shores or sides of the river, obviously it will have sand content also. That is the advantage. It will have sand, required sand content. Then they do this process of kneading, tempering, puddling, then molding. They have the potter's wheel. It's very famous. Usually that potter's wheel is used in so many occasions in movies. In movies, especially art movies, it is an analogical model conveying some realities. The realities may be the pleasing realities or frustrating realities, whatever it may be. You have the potter's wheel. They will be manually rotating it and carving it using their hands. You get pots of water pots, you get cooking pots, cooking bowls. People say, suppose you cook food on potteries, the taste of the food will be more. Because one reason will be because of it is the taste of the set. In evolving and realizing the spot, knowing very well that its longitude will be very less. But if proper maintenance and proper care is taken on well-baked pottery, and at that time usually people were cooking sitting in the ground, so possibility of falling is less. Now since the kitchen has been elevated, kitchen platform, Cooking process has been elevated. It is brittle. The potteries are brittle. So once they fall, it will break. So possibility of breakage will be more. But it is a sustainable material. Only if that break again, people will go there and get another one, by which their livelihood will flourish. So coming back to brick. A ceramic material, the mold is ready. This, you have a steel plate at the bottom. When the mold is full of, correctly filled and trimmed, it will be taken and kept under shade. It will not be allowed to be exposed to direct sun, because there will be superficial cracks. When superficial cracks come, the whole job is a waste. So you keep the brick underneath the shaded area. If you don't have a shaded area, they will put a tarpaulin or some covering below that they will keep. Aeration is a must. So the brick kept And you, while making the brick, in the steel plate which is kept at the bottom, there will be a projection. There will be a projection. This projection obviously will induce a depression on the surface of the brick. This projection will obviously induce a depression on the surface. That depression on the surface of the brick is called flaw. I am yet to know why that name has been given to it, but that name is F-R-O-G, flaw. Any explicit depression on one side, one surface of the brick, or both the surfaces. Both the surfaces. Name is flaw. So you take from the steel plate, go there, make it upside down, remove the steel plate, gradually remove the mold also. Now all the sides and surfaces will be under the shade, at least for 24 hours. So that is known as the stacking of the bricks. Drying of the brick. Drying of the brick. When you do it, you should not keep the bricks very much adjacent. You should give sufficient space. And it should be done in one row. Only when the brick becomes little dry, you can keep one more over that. Anyway, it is better to keep the bricks horizontally in one row, wait for some time, then stack. When you do that, if you keep the brick, usually the brick size is 9 inches by 4.5 inches by 3 inches. Usually the brick will be laid on its face while you are laying the brickwork for superstructure. It will be laid on its face, that is the 9 inches by 4.5 inches face. But while you are stacking for seasoning or curing the brick, you keep brick on edge. That's a particular fashion of laying the brick in masonry too. Brick on edge. So more surface area will be exposed to the daylight, by which the excess water will be dried up to make it surface dry condition. So bricks will, while you are stacking the bricks, bricks have to be laid on their edges, on the 3 inches size. The brick 9 inches by 4.5 inches by 3 inches is called a country brick. It's called a country brick. A brick usually having a size of 19 centimeter by 9 centimeter by 9 centimeter. While you are laying them, there will be joints in which you will be putting a binder, keep them in the masonry. Ultimately, you will get 20 centimeter by 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter. The bricks are of this size, 20 centimeter by 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter. That brick is called modular brick. Module means multiple of 10. So 20, 10 and 10. So modular bricks. So you have country bricks and modular bricks. So we are coming to the process of brick making, in which this has been told, while stacking the brick before baking it or burning the brick. Next process is the burning the brick. If you are going to have temporary burning of bricks by stacking them in a particular fashion, by providing the ovens, fireplaces in which firewood will be filled and they will be burned after stacking the brick in a particular fashion, covering it with mud. That stacking, covering, and using fireplaces underneath. And if you start burning the brick, that process is called clamp burning. That structure is called a clamp. Around lakhs, 2 lakhs bricks will be piled up in a particular fashion and burned from the bottom. We will continue by God's grace tomorrow. What is the next type of brick burning? Thank you. God bless.